never be the same, it'll never be for sure.
You know,
shit'll never be the same, never be the same, never be the same, never be the same. Oh, you cuffed me once, I never let you do it again. You cuffed me twice, and best believe I'm doing you in. I'm not religious, I ain't come doing this in. The flight boss in the sky, and he blowing the wind.
Flight boss, bitch, goddamn air. And right now, we're gonna talk about what is spiritual strength. Now, for the most part, I wanna break this down, cause look, this video could be helpful for all my atheists out there. Cause a lot of y'all got enormous spiritual strength, a lot more than others, and y'all don't even believe in a goddamn spirit. So it kind of baffles me at times. So let me go ahead and break it down in third dimensional terms so everybody can understand it. So it don't have to be no arguments and debates out in the world amongst theologians and atheists and things of that nature, whether y'all choose to believe what I'm talking about or not. Now, like I said, your spirit is no thing, not nothing, the way scientists is trying to teach you, so you can create this kind of world or this perception or this spaceship, aka a mind state, that's something that is nothing, and whatever that consists of. That's the actual space that our spirits and bodies are creating. So I don't want people to create a space of nothing. I want people to understand that no thing doesn't necessarily mean nothing. It just means no thing. And what y'all consider to be a thing in this realm of reality is based upon a third dimension. You know, you got the periodic table, you got a bunch of different shapes and forms, you got fleshly fluids, you got a body. All these are perceived to be things. You see what I'm saying? So when I say a spirit is no thing, in this realm of reality, y'all can't even consider what's nothing yet. So for the most part, let's not even get there. But let's talk about it like this. What is spiritual strength? Spiritual strength is nothing more, nothing less, but the ability to endure your circumstances and situations. Now, since your spirit is no thing, no shape and form, right? Whatever you are enduring is external to you. It's outside of you. So that's circumstances, situation, the surroundings you're in, the people, places, and things. Now, no one know how you endure these things unless you express it through a vessel, through your body, through your emotions, through your ideas, through your verbal communication. That's the only way anyone kind of know your spiritual strength. You see what I'm saying? And you ain't even got to call it spiritual strength. You could kind of be a scientist and turn it to your neurons, signals, and shit like that. You could get lost into that. But for the most part, that's like an infinite regress. And your ass ain't going to never find the root cause of whatever you're trying to find as a scientist. So y'all better start getting into goddamn spirituality. You know what I'm saying? And stop being goddamn Satans, being opposing. That's what a scientist is, a Satan, being opposing to the actual energies that's accumulating things, and you just want to be opposing and want to study the thing that's already accumulated. But for the most part, spiritual strength is just the ability to endure the circumstances and situations that you go through. So you have certain people who go through circumstances and situations, and they may go through it weak. People can't handle shit. They get overwhelmed by the current and the influence. You see what I'm saying? They might be spiritually weak. You know what I'm saying? People who are spiritually strong always can find a way over the hurdle, over the shape and form, over the thing that we are wrapped up in and mingling in as spirits. You see what I'm saying? So when you know how to rise above, regardless of how the circumstance may look, your ability to show people that, well, your ability to not allow other people to see you sweat, that means inside this body, inside this vessel, your spirit's strong as hell. Because it ain't lost in any of the chakras to create an influence for other people to pick up so they can point out what kind of space that you are in. Or see where your river is coming from. See where you coming from. You ain't got that ability. And if anybody want to see where you coming from, it's coming from a higher place. Because you're not letting it drag you down underneath. You get what I'm saying? So for the most part, that's spiritual strength. You got enough spiritual strength to withstand the motherfucking esoteric currents, the esoteric waters, which is these stars, these chakras and shit like that, and you don't even get lost into your own. Because a lot of times we create our own circumstances and situations, and then we get lost into our own mess. And all the shit that we manifest, we left to deal with those responsibilities. So you could be a spiritually weak person or a spiritually strong person. Atheist, if you don't like the word spirit, then it's utilize yourself, to say yourself. Or your internal. But goddamn it, it's gonna be attached to the goddamn word spirit in some way, shape, or form. So you might as well just get with the program. And I know y'all get lost because religion is just one way of explaining spirituality. So look at it like this. A religion is a real legion, aka we all spirits and bodies. So when you got one spirit with their philosophical point of view about what we're all doing, and if they get a lot of followers, it could turn into a real legion, a religion, a whole bunch of spirits who think we're all doing things in that way. So it becomes a culture or a cult. You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, religion ain't the author of spirituality. Now, it might be the author of the goddamn word. So like I said, we could give it a whole nother word. But goddamn, you is just you. And it's no thing. You see what I'm saying? It's no shape and form. So how you endure these things, you have to utilize your shape and form in order for anybody to know how you are expressing these things. Or the shapes and forms that you're manifesting in your life are representations of whatever spiritual state of being you are in. But as far as just you being you, with no one else around, even without your flesh, when you close your fucking eyes, goddammit, you just that. So if you don't want to call it a goddamn spirit, I don't know what else you want to motherfucking call it. But what I'm telling you is this. Spiritual strength is your ability to endure the circumstances and situations that you are in. Your ability to handle these things when you are alone and when you are around others. And the more you can't do these things, the more that shows you that's an example that you need a little bit more spiritual strength. And one of the heaviest weights in the esoteric realm is the satisfaction energy. And look, in all energies, don't call your spirit the energy. Your spirit ain't energy. Your spirit create energy. Your spirit create force. Energy is what the fuck you looking at as far as chakras, solar systems, motherfucker. And energy manifests and gets condensed into the physical shapes and forms you see today. Your spirit ain't becoming physical, motherfucker. So stop saying that. I know we lost, but we're getting out of that. I'm here now. And people like me are here now. So we no longer have to be lost into these third dimensional aspects of what we think the spirit is. You see what I'm saying? So for the most part, your spirit create these goddamn things. If you're going to keep calling your spirit these things and keep thinking creation come from energy, then that's going to lead you into infinite regress. Because you're going to be trying to find where the energy started. And that's just basically the masculine energy. What is history? History is tracking the masculine energy. Masculine energy is pushing out. Anytime you push out from the feminine energy. So if you're trying to track something from the masculine energy, you're never going to find it. You're never going to find the root. How are you going to find the root trying to track something that came second? You're always going to find something that came second. You're never going to find the first, aka infinite regress. Do y'all hear me? So, you need to understand, like, when we're talking about spiritual strength, one of the heaviest boulders to lift is satisfaction. The spirit, for some reason, it have a hard time lifting that weight. Once it stay in that space a little bit, it leaves. But if you can be satisfied, rather with circumstance or situation you in, the longer you can stay in that space, you lifting weights. But like I said, you could be a person who go to Planet Fitness every day. That don't mean lift weights all fucking day. Your muscles need to relax. So as a spirit, you need to work with your spirituality. Work with your spiritual strength. Know where you're weak at. Know what you need to do. Know what kind of access you need. Know what kind of... And a lot of times, this may not even have anything to do with physical realm of reality. But it might be a lot of things in the third dimension that represent that state of being. So for an example, it might be certain things that you can do. Herbs, oils, weed, meditation. It's a lot of physical representations in this realm of reality that represents a state of being that you could be in. But it's just the lower version of it down here. It could be a mental concept or a feeling and emotion. That's a creation that got created out of the space that you are in. And it got brought down into the third dimension. And now that's like a tool you can use to get to that space. Because that space is really no thing. Because space is spirit. You see what I'm saying? So you got your space. You know what you want in your space. You know what you want to X out of your fucking space. You know what's harming your space. You know when you start to feel suffocated based upon your material, your relationships, or whatever. You could be right next to one person and right next to another person. And feel suffocated by one person and feel truly free next to the other person. And both of these people are on both sides of you. Now, how did that work? Why you felt like that, though? You felt like that. But when you looking side to side, both of these people is right next to you. But when you look at one of the persons, this person, motherfucking, make you feel like you smothered. When you look at the other motherfucker, You feel like you could be free with these motherfuckers, but both of them right next to you. So goddamn it, if you're gonna hate on the word spirit or whatever like that, give it another name. But goddamn it, it exists. Flight boss, bitch, goddamn it, that's spiritual strength in this motherfucker. Love y'all, and we gonna live tonight.